Hi, this is Peter from the LAB team, and in this video we are gonna have a look at how to add additional descriptors to our drawings. Let's say we want some custom descriptors, so let's start the LAB control application and connect to our database. Okay. So here we have some drawings and each of them has a sample ID, but let's say we would like to have additional information recorded, as such as the feature in from which the sample is, or that contains the sample, and maybe also some additional info on the sample itself, so like painting, whether the sample is painted or the weight of the fragment. Okay, so before we do that, let's have a look at the database which the LAP application uses. It's the database system is called Deposit. It's also custom developed. It's open source, and you can also download it separately and install it. Deposit is a graph database, and for now, what's important to understand is that it uses classes and descriptors, among other things. So classes, you can imagine a class as a, let's say, a table in a regular database or in a spreadsheet, and a descriptor as a column. So if we open the class sample, you see this is the main class where the drawings are stored. So here we have the sample ID, the descriptor ID of the class sample. This is how we write it. Whether the sample has a rim, bottom, the radius is recorded here. Here's the polygons, so the profile is here as a polygon, some point data, and also the reconstruction in SVG format is available here. So you see there is other classes here. So for example, arc is the arcs of curvature which are captured to reconstruct the diameter of the sample of the fragment. And also, for example, here we have the class photo, which contains the captured images. We can use here the image view, sorry, the image view to see the something like thumbnails, preview of the images. Open them. I could just use the drag and drop function to, if I wanted to store the image somewhere else, and just drag and drop it to the desktop, for example, it's a regular JPEG. Okay, so this is Deposit, and besides classes and their descriptors, we have to somehow link all this information together, because we need to be able to reconstruct or reassemble the drawing from all this information that's stored separately. And for that, we have relations between those classes, and we can have a look at how the relations look in this using this function. This draws a graph, a visual representation of the graph, since it's a graph database. Where here we see all the classes. We can switch to attribute view or the descriptor view, so we can see all the descriptors of the classes. You can right click and drag the mouse to navigate here, and here you see the sample class with its descriptors and also the relations. So the sample is drawn by the photo, so which means in this case that the photo is a part of this drawing of the sample. And so here's the detail handle, there's a handle, and so on and so on. So okay, so this is basically how Deposit works. We have classes, their descriptors, and they are linked by relations. And why I'm explaining this to you is because we want to add additional information. So let's say we have we have a spreadsheet. This is one way to add the information. So let's say we have the information in or these descriptors in a separate database, and we can just get it in the form of a spreadsheet, of an Excel table. So here we have the sample ID, and you see the sample IDs are the same as in our database. Sorry, as in the deposit database. So yeah, the sample number, sample IDs, and we want to add additional information about the feature where the sample is contained, the area where the feature is contained. So it's like an excavation area. Then for each sample, we want to specify where, whether it's painted or not, and let's say weight of the sample in grams of the fragment. So to import this data, you open deposit, and either you can use this the tool, the load external data function, or just drag and drop the Excel file on this area here. It will open as an external data source. And okay, so here you see the data from the spreadsheet. You would see if it was several workbooks, you could switch here between them. And here you see the column names. And here the thing is that deposit, the class names in deposit and also descriptor names, they shouldn't contain, or they cannot contain spaces, and they cannot contain characters like parentheses or apostrophes. Also, you shouldn't use diacritics. So that's one thing. We want to change the names of the descriptors, and we also have to specify the structure. So where should each data go? So sample ID, that's information that we already have in the database. Here, if you open the sample class, the ID is already here. So we will use this to link the data correctly. So I have to double click here and specify where this information goes. It's sample, the class sample dot, and the descriptor is ID. So it will fill or it will match with this descriptor here. Enter. Okay, feature. We want the information of the features. You see that the feature repeats. So we don't want just a descriptor of the class sample, which would read the feature, but we want a class feature, which will contain unique features. And we want to link it with the sample class so that the sample is contained in the feature. So let's demonstrate this. So here we enter the class is feature, the descriptor is name. Then we have the class area, descriptor name, class where, also name. So basically, if we have nominal values which we want to have as dictionaries, we create separate classes. But for the information whether the sample is painted or not, it's a simple boolean or it's one or a zero, true or false. So we want to that descriptor to be part of the sample class. Sample painted. And with the information on weight, we have to, this is also a unique descriptor for each sample, so we don't have to create a separate class for it. But so we add it to the sample class, but we have to get rid of these characters here, which the deposit doesn't support, so it should look like this. 18 grams. I just expand the column here a little. Okay, so now everything is specified. I click import here, import data. And The last thing to do is I have to specify relations, if you remember the links between the classes. So we have the sample class, it's clear that then we have the feature class, and we have to specify that the feature contains the sample. So the class feature has a relation that's named contains with the class sample. Also, the area contains the feature. And then we have the where class, so that's a lookup descriptor of the sample class. So we can specify it like this, sample as a descriptor. That's a way how I do it, but you could use a different name for the relation, of course. A sample has a descriptor where. And here we don't have to specify any additional relations. So I click OK. I can close this. And now let's see what has happened. So first in the relations view or in the graph visualization, you can switch directly to attributes. So we have some new classes here. It's the area class and the feature class. And we see that the relations have been created here. So the area contains the feature and that contains the sample. And we have some another class here, where that's a descriptor of the sample. And now if we open the class, I would look at the data, so I can just double click the class there and it opens up the table view. So this is all the data that was there already, and here we have the new descriptor, so whether the sample is painted and the weight of the sample. And you see it has been correctly matched to the sample IDs here. And so what happens to the features and to the areas? So if I open the area class here, you see we have now area A and B, as was specified in the imported data. That's we only have these two areas. So this is like a lookup table now. And if I open the entry here, I double click it and look at the area A, I see that it contains these two features. And if I open this feature here, I double click it again, I can see it contains these samples. And also that it is contained in area A. So this symbol means that it's a reverse relation. So the relation goes from area to feature here. Okay. So now we have the data in our database. I could use this now. For example, I could make a simple query. I want to select query all samples from area A. So select sample, that's the class ID, that's the descriptor. Let's see. Let's say I want the IDs and sample profiles. File. It's the profile descriptor here, right? And where? And since it's already everything is linked, I don't have to specify any linkage here. The software knows that the area is linked to the sample, so I just specify where area name equals, I have to use double equals, that's the Pythonic way, so because this software is programmed in Python and it supports Python expressions here in the where portion of the query. So area name equals A in single quotes, enter, and we see here all the samples that are contained in features which are contained in the area A have been listed. Okay, so now we have the data in the database, but we still don't have it in in our software. So if I open a sample here, it opens, but we don't have this additional information displayed here. So what we have to do is tell the LAP control application that we want these descriptors to be displayed. So I clicked on edit descriptor here, and I can add more user defined descriptors. So this will be feature. It will be not a line edit, but a combo box, because I want it to be a dictionary. I want to be able to look up the feature. And here's a little hint that was this displayed. So it's the feature name. I don't have to specify the relations now, because the relations are already specified in the database. Area name, and whether the sample is painted. Sample painted and weight. Sample. So this will be a line edit, but the painted is a true or false, yes or no option. So I can use a checkbox for that. It will be simpler. And to remember here, area should be a combo box as well. So I click OK. The descriptors are here now. And if I open a drawing again, you will notice also that I mistyped the weight descriptor should be weight grams. Grams. I can edit it here. Okay. And you see also in the browser the new columns have been added here. Also the feature name, the area name, sample painted weight grams. And when I open it, it's already here visible, and I can just edit this values here. When I click store, it will be updated in the database. So this is one way how to add the descriptors. If in case we have them already in an external file, like in a spreadsheet. But let's remove this for now. Okay. Reload the database. Don't want to import. So let's say I want to manually add some descriptors that I don't have them available outside. So I can do it simply just from the LAP control application. I click data edit descriptors, add a new field here, feature, combo box. And since now the this class is not the feature class is not does not exist in the database, and the relations are not specified, so I have to use, as the hint says here, I have to use the notation class, relation class, and descriptor. So class would be I have to first say sample, and now it's I have to use a reverse relation, so it's contained, so tilt and contains feature name. So I had to use a reverse relation, because I have to specify also the descriptor. So this is the class feature descriptor name, and I have to specify that it's in this relation to a class that's already existing here. So that's sample. So now I can add the area descriptor again, combo box, and here I do the same, but with feature contains sample. So feature is contained in the area. So feature is contained in contains area name and pane. And this will be a checkbox, and it's a unique descriptor for each sample. So it's a descriptor of the class sample. So sample. Okay. And when we have a look at the database now, open deposit. You can see now the class sample has a new descriptor painting, and if you look at the structure, the classes area and feature have been created as we have specified. So all is as before, and I can just use it now and enter the data. Of course, these descriptors will be, the columns will be empty. I have to fill them in manually. So this would be feature A 10, area 10, specify it's painted, store it. And the data is here. So this is how you add additional descriptors to your database. You can, of course, again, export the data as I have shown in another tutorial. I can just export it in an Excel format as a work Excel workbook, or I can just select all, copy or Control C, and I can just paste it into a spreadsheet or similar application. Should work with any similar application. Here we have an error because Excel has a problem with the length of the on a single cell of the text is too long. I think it's like 32,000 characters maximum. So these polygon fields are way, way too long. The specifications of the polygons, they are way too long for Excel. So I should restrict this to data that Excel can handle. So let's say just these data here. They get pasted properly. Okay, so this concludes this tutorial. Have a nice day.